During the Civil War, the women's rights activists stopped their fight for the vote, and instead they put all their attention into petitioning for a 13th Amendment to end slavery in the entire United States and the territories.
When the war ended, slavery was abolished, and both the women's rights movement and African Americans thought they would gain the right to vote together.
They were very disappointed when the Republican Congress decided to only write the 14th and then the 15th Amendments in ways that excluded women. And the way that they did that is that the 14th Amendment stated that anyone born on American soil was an American citizen, and this potentially gave everyone the right to vote. However, the second clause in the 14th Amendment listed the word male in a sentence about voting and representation. And by doing that, it introduced the word male into the Constitution for the very first time. Women were extremely upset that the 14th Amendment added the word male like that in a sentence about voting. And it was even worse for them when the 15th Amendment was passed in 1870, because the 15th Amendment allowed only black men to vote and not black women or white women. It created a split not only with suffragists, women suffragists and abolitionists, but also amongst the women suffragists between two different groups. Some of them went with Frederick Douglass and Lucy Stone and created a group called the American Woman Suffrage Association that said, well, we're not going to fight against the 14th and 15th Amendments. We're going to accept them even though they limit suffrage to men. But we're going to fight right away for what they envisioned was going to be the 16th Amendment. And it would come soon, and it would be the way for black and white women to get the right to vote. Whereas the group that went with Elizabeth Cady Stanton and Susan B. Anthony, they formed the National Woman Suffrage Association. And that group also had another amendment in mind, but wanted to fight against the 14th and 15th Amendments as being unacceptable. But because women had separated into two different groups to fight for women's suffrage, they found it very hard to make progress, I think because they were divided in the 1870s and 1880s. So in 1890, they reunited into a group called the National American Woman Suffrage Association, which they sometimes call NASA. And this one group in 1890 decided to focus on several different ways to get the right to vote for black and white women. And one thing that they tried to do was to increase the number of states where women had the right to vote, with the ultimate idea that there would be enough members of Congress who had women voters in their state that they would feel pressured to vote for an amendment for woman suffrage. And eventually that did happen with a combination of this state-by-state work, lobbying in Congress, protesting, picketing the White House in the 1910s and during World War I, very radical activism where they actually were doing hunger strikes in prison. All of these things together led to women finally gaining the right to vote, and that was in 1920 with the 19th Amendment.